Here's the scenario. You or your company depend on Dropbox or Google Drive because you already have a lot of data there. Now, right now, Google Drive doesn't have the same problem as Dropbox, but it may happen in the future. But one of the problems that Google Drive has is data transfer limits, 750 gigabytes per user. So let's say here, let's put ourselves in the Dropbox situation. Dropbox will be dropping support for syncing external drives with Dropbox. They're going to be only supporting having the Dropbox folder in your internal disk. And for a lot of people, that's a problem. And I know of people that have that problem. Now, what can you do? If you use Synology NAS, so any Synology server, or you use BIOS Cloud, which is my cloud storage based on Synology servers, you can still have your external disk being synced using the Synology NAS that is connected to Dropbox. And this is what I'm gonna show you now. So here the scenario is that we are storing things into Dropbox, we are retrieving from Dropbox, but we are syncing through Synology Drive to an external disk. So let's take a look on the computer to see how we are doing that. All right, the first thing that I want to set up is actually an external drive to sync with Dropbox. I will add a volume to my SSD here that I will just call Dropbox in order to be easy to identify. So there you go. I have my Dropbox drive here is an external SSD. And there is nothing in it, of course. The second thing that I want to do is set up Synology Drive. So I'm opening now Synology Drive. I will add the address of my Synology NAS. That could be an internal IP from your company, or it could be an external address, for example, for BIOS Cloud. So I'm going to use here my own. You add your username and hit next. Then I will create a sync task. And on the Synology Drive, I already created a shared folder called Dropbox for this demo. So here it is, that folder that is on the NAS, and I will choose to sync it to my external SSD called Dropbox. Okay, click done. And now they're both in sync. At the moment, there is nothing because really we don't have that connection going yet. If I open here my Dropbox account, I have one of those free accounts, so it doesn't have a lot of things. So here it is, some folders with some projects, and this is what we want to get to our Dropbox SSD that is on this computer. Now using Synology NAS, we're gonna use Cloud Sync and we're gonna select Dropbox, click next. We're gonna authenticate to my Dropbox account and agree. And now I can choose what's going to be the local path on my Synology NAS, which is the Dropbox folder, select, then the remote path, which will remain to be the root folder. I want everything there. Now, if you didn't want everything and you still wanted to map the root folder, you could just click on next and then advanced settings and choose which folder specifically you want to sync. So you don't really have to download all of those petabytes of data that you have on Dropbox. You can download just what you need and you can always come back here to do that. And then click done. And then okay. Now Cloud Sync is starting to download things. And I can see here the progress in terms of speed, at which speed things are being downloaded. And of course, there is a bunch of very small files there on my Dropbox. And at the same time, these files are being sent to Synology Drive and they are appearing now on my drive. So here it is, my external drive. It now has all the folders from Dropbox. They're being downloaded. I'm going to actually do a calculate all sizes here. So we see the progress of the data coming through. And as Cloud Sync on the Synology is downloading those files, they are immediately being sent to my external SSD through Synology Drive. I will speed up this video just in order for us to see this finishing here. But one thing that I wanted to show you here, I don't know if you caught, but Dropbox is only letting me download at 40 something megabytes a second. And look at this, my Synology that is in the data center is actually uploading to me here at a much faster speed. So this is one of the advantages that we end up getting if, for example, you are able to deploy a server, a Synology server in a data center, like I am with my Bias Cloud offering. But okay, so let's speed up and go to the end of this. All right, download has finished. So I have all of my projects here on my SSD. The Synology NAS itself is completely synced. You see, it's all up to date. And now I want to show you something that is very nice here, which is how everything stays in sync even though I don't have Dropbox installed on my computer. So for example, if I come here and I change the name of this folder from Hogwarts Legacy to, let's say, just Hogwarts, we're going to see that update happening here as well. There it is. Now we have just as YouTube Hogwarts. The same thing if I wanted to delete that folder, it would delete immediately from here. So I will delete that folder and it will immediately delete here from Dropbox. So we are very much in sync here. So I hope this helps you to have an idea on how a Synology NAS can help your workflow, even though you're using Dropbox or Google Drive or any other cloud storage. It's possible to do this with a lot of things. And in case you, for example, don't have the budget to go there and buy a Synology NAS for yourself, there is always people like me that I have already all the infrastructure, and you can basically buy space the same way as you would for Dropbox or Google Drive. Now, you don't need to pay for both Dropbox and Google Drive. You could be just using Synology Drive with Bias Cloud, for example. So there are so many options. I hope this has been helpful for you. And obviously, don't forget to subscribe, like this video, share with your friends, and I see you in the next one. Bye-bye.